Now we're going to talk comics for the next few moments because events are being held to celebrate the 80th birthday of the Beano. The comedian David Walliams has edited a special issue of the comic, which was created in Dundee, and that city's McManus Museum has been temporarily renamed the McMenis in honour of, yes, Dennis the Menace. Well, here to tell us more, Emma Scott, who's the chief executive of Beano Studios. Welcome and happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
I touched on some of the celebrations. What else is planned?
Well, here's the special edition, which I brought in for you, Julian. And we've relaunched the fan club today, so you have your special badge. I expect you to wear it later.
Okay, right. Thank you.
But yes, Beano's 80, going strong. We're very good at reinventing ourselves over and over. Thank you. We're celebrating today and hopefully another 80 years to come.
Yeah. What's kept it as successful? There we are. We can now see it. What's kept it as successful as it's been for such a long time, given everybody's changing tastes in so many other ways?
Absolutely. I think it's we take a 4-foot high view of the world. We're about children. We talk to kids every week. We know what they're interested in. The characters in the comic are children themselves, which is quite rare. And we've kept the characters going. We've sort of changed what they do and what they're interested in. And we have a big digital proposition with Beano.com as well. So we've got the print, and we've got digital, and we've got TV.
Mm. I think we can show you as a cartoon at this point in the conversation.
Yes.
There we are, look.
Very lucky to be drawn by Nigel Parkinson, who has been drawing Dennis for over 35 years. And, you know, I think the great legacy of what we have with Beano is a great love from parents in this country that carries on, and great trust. I mean, we've got double the trust score of YouTube, for example, with parents in this country. And I think that therefore allows us to carry on with more and more generations of kids.
Talk to me about the David Walliams role and what he's done here.
Yeah, so we asked David whether he'd like to guest edit. He jumped at the chance, and he, you know, proved to be a big fan from a young age and knows the comic very, very well. And he got very involved, so he worked with the comic team on taking some of his characters and integrating them. And obviously we brought him to life. And he asked for a donation to Young Minds, which is a charity. We work with the child mental health charity, so we were delighted to do that. And actually in the comic, we've created a comic strip for Young Minds, which is actually one of the great ways of staying relevant. So it's a comic story about a girl getting her first mobile phone, because we know that that's a pinch point with children.
As we talk, we're just showing some of the Beanos through the ages, I suppose, is the best way to describe it. Different images from different eras. Some of them are very striking, aren't they? I mean, there's a Dennis the Menace page in black and white, obviously. Have you had a chance to sort of look nostalgically back in recent days?
Yes. I mean, I'm lucky enough to have been to the archive in Dundee as well, which has both the sort of the very first copy through to today. And the artists have changed over the years, although there are some very consistent ones. Dave Sutherland, who draws the Bass Street Kids, is in his 90s and still draws it, hand draws it and delivers it every week. You know, and it's a great privilege to be able to look back. So the Dennis today is possibly different to the one when you were a boy, but he's still the mischievous
very
rascal. we won't ask you your age, but...
No, but I think you're right. I think you make a fair assumption. Listen, thank you so much for coming in and for bringing this. And as I say, happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Emma.